Hello, 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 my lovely mystic tribe. This is your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Okay, this is going to be a general reading, just like always. And every star sign will be listed, will be time stamped in the description box below. If you would like a private reading with me, do see the description box as well. There is my website, my email address. You can follow me on social media, Facebook and Instagram. And these readings are meant to be short and sweet because there's only so much energies for a daily. A daily is supposed to be just that, daily guidance. Okay, I know there's other readers here on YouTube that have these long 15, 20 minute readings for a daily. There's just, it's more giving of long-term projections than it is a daily focus. My goal is a daily focus, and that's what these are about, right? Okay, now, you also want to make sure you check out your sun, rising, moon, and Venus signs. Feel free to cross-watch if you have somebody you want to spy on. You know, we all have that one person or that two people that we like to spy on and see what's up, right? Don't lie. You know you want to spy on somebody. Anyhow, make sure you, oh, by the way, I almost forgot one of the important things. Hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, share, and comment. Make sure you hit that notification bell so that you are notified when I upload new videos, when I have my giveaway, shout outs to my winners, and when I do my free reading Wednesdays, and I'm having a bonus free reading. Yes, yes, yes. Tomorrow, on Sunday morning at 11 a.m. on April 25th, Sunday, Eastern Time, I am going live. And I am unboxing some things. One of them, I'll tell you, it is an Oracle deck that a dear, sweet, lovely subscriber sent to me. And I've also had her as a client, read for her privately, sent me some stuff. Even some excerpts besides the Oracle deck. So I'm going to have a walkthrough of that Oracle deck. I'm not telling you what Oracle deck it is yet. I was tempted to just go ahead and read with it tonight. But I said, nope, 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 nope. I got to be disciplined. I got to wait. You know, it's like that kid at Christmas time. You want to open the package. You know, I wanted to open up and look at these cards. But I took on the energy of the strength card in the tarot and restrained myself. I held back. But tomorrow morning, we're going to unbox it. Then I'm going to do free card pulls, free messages. You know, not really people asking questions, just pulling cards for people of a message from that Oracle deck. It is awesome. I know, I've already YouTubed it. Anyhow, we're already over 3 minutes into this and I haven't even pulled the daily. I haven't even pulled the message for the collective yet. So we're going to see what the Ascended Masters have to say. Who wants to speak to the collective for the 26th of April? This one wants to come out. Okay. Let's see. Who is speaking to us today? And you know me, I suck at pronunciations. But Mavatar, Babaji, I don't know, soul expansion. Your consciousness is expanding. You understand the connection between all things. Beautiful message. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started into the readings. That's what you're here for, right? Okay, let's go. Hello, Aries. Welcome to your daily reading. Let's see what Spirit has for you for the 26th of April. Holy Spirit, angel spirits, and guides. Okay. Okay, as we continue, what are the messages for Aries, please? Okay, let's see what we have. Let's get two more cards. What the hell? Right? Let's get one more card. Okay, Aries. What we have is, it looks like the day is starting out nice, bright, sunny. Of course, depending on where you are in the world, right? Happy times, feeling alive, vitality. Two of Pentacles. You know, it seems like everything is in perfect balance as the start of your day. Lovely energy here. Okay. Because I feel as though that you are going to be happy. You've made the choice. Instead of going back and forth, you made the choice to be balanced. You're making the choice to put any kind of painful situation behind you. You're walking away from pain. You're not acknowledging it anymore. You're not letting it control you anymore. And you are getting out of that mentality of being cold, being trapped in a situation. You're leaving that mentality behind. You might have had some money problems, because we do have some struggles here with a Ten of Swords, some problems, along with the Eight of Swords, some mental conflict here, mental blockages. I feel as though that you are allowing money to get in the way of your happiness, maybe the lack of money, but I feel as though you're leaving all that struggles behind on the 26th, and you are choosing to be happy, you know, and that is the key. That's the key, Aries, changing your mindset, being happy, thinking positive, getting rid of the negative stuff, getting rid of the fear of being left out in the cold, getting rid of, you know, the feeling pinned down and feeling stuck and, you know, and getting out of that mindset, knowing that you have a choice. You have a choice to do what makes you happy. And I think that's where you are headed. Okay, that's what I have for you, Aries. Bye. Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26, 2021. Okay, Holy Spirit, angels, spirits, and gods, what are the blessed messages for Taurus, please? Blessed messages for Taurus. Okay, what does Taurus need to know about the 26th? Okay, let's see where we're at here. Okay, we do have the Nine of Cups came up in the reverse. We do have, and we have the Queen of Swords. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have the Nine of Pentacles. This is the Pre-Empress energy, and that's actually Virgo energy. We have the Two of Cups. We have Page of Wands. The World card, Capricorn energy. And yet an extra card, which is the Two of Pentacles that also fell out for you. So this is an extra card. This is the theme. This is talking about this back and forth bull crap, you know. Do I or don't I? Who do I choose? What do I choose? What path do I choose? I know that, you know, I need to go somewhere, you know. But, you know, I kind of want to go backwards, but there's blockages. Okay, there's obstacles. Or do I want to take the easy way? Okay, that's kind of the energy that you're going to be in. And I feel as though that you are in a space where that you are kind of like denying your wish fulfillment. Okay, I feel like it's a wish fulfillment in love or partnership. This could be business. Two of Cups doesn't have to be romantic. It could be a business partnership. It could be a friendship, okay? For some of you, maybe it was a friendship that you were hoping would go to the next level and hasn't. Hasn't yet. There's been delays. Or for some of you, you know, you may have, it may be a case of being careful what you wish for. Almost, or somebody may have wished you into their life, however it resonates. But it feels like a wish that you put out there concerning a relationship did not turn out the way that you had planned, okay? And you might be dealing with this Queen of Swords, okay? It seems like what you ended up with was somebody who lacked emotion, okay? who may have been so used to being very analytical in their head, very straight to the point. She wants justice. She wants truth, male or female, doesn't matter who that queen is. This queen is an energy. I'm saying she because it's an energy, okay? So she is very much, you know, maybe she came in the way, she may be the obstacle of your wish fulfillment, okay? And now you are looking, wondering if you can turn back and turn back the hands of time. A time when you were abundant, a time when you felt complete and very secure, a time when you felt complete with the World card, okay? You felt complete, you felt very abundant, you had everything that you wanted, including love. Love, money, stability, nurturing, you had it all, okay? But I feel as though that you made a choice at some point that maybe there was something else lacking that you wanted more of. And you got your wish, but it turned out not to be what it was. So, right, I feel as though on the 26th Taurus, you are going to be tossing back and forth. Do I attempt to go backwards to where I was comfortable, to where I know was comfortable, where I used what I had, even though there's obstacles and blocks that I need to overcome and complete this cycle? Or do I stay where I'm at and just continue on? I think that that is where you're going to be at on Monday. Okay, that's what I have for you. Bye. Hello, Gemini. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26, 2021. Holy Spirit, angels, spirits, and guides, clarity, messages, guides, please, for Gemini. Okay, we have the Five of Pentacles, Eight of Cups, Ten of Pentacles. You're going after your Ten of Pentacles. The Strength card, Leo energy. Eight of Pentacles. And Ace of Wands. Under the deck, you have the Hierophant, Taurus energy. Okay, and Four of Swords, taking a rest, taking a break. Hierophant is a higher level of commitment. It is a commitment. It is also could be something very spiritual as well. So what I feel is going on here, you are having the strength and the courage to overcome some sense of lack of in your life. I feel like you feel very alone is what I'm picking up here. Okay. You're feeling alone, but you are moving forward toward away from something emotionally unfulfilling here. And you are moving towards something stable, secure. I feel as though that you are overcoming some obstacles. You know, I'm seeing a lot of pentacles here. This could be work related, actually, because we have three pentacles. Okay. And I feel as though that if for some of you, if this is work related, you're leaving a job that wasn't paying you what you needed to make ends meet. It might be a bittersweet departure, but I feel as though that you are moving on to a position that is going to grant you more stability, more abundance, and a whole new path. Of course, it does involve you signing some kind of commitment. It's going to require a commitment. So you might be going into a brand new passionate beginning, passionate commitment, contract signing, and following your higher self, following your inner guidance towards a career or job that is going to pay more money and give you that financial stability. For others of you, if love and romance, what I'm seeing is somebody is leaving a relationship. Maybe they were dealing with a Leo here, but that's a number eight. Overcome, having the courage and the strength to overcome some blockages that, you know, that were emotional blockages, a relationship that has grown cold, and starting a new passionate beginning that could lead to a higher level of commitment, even marriage, that is going to have something stable. So I think Monday, for some of you, this is goodbyes in some way, shape, or form. You know, whether this is work, career, personal relationships, or general life. Okay? But that's what I have for you, Gemini. Bye. Hello, Cancer. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26, 2021. Holy Spirit, angel spirits, and guides, clarity, messages, guidance, please, for Cancer. Let's see what we have so far. We have the Star card, Aquarius energy. We have the Ace of Wands. I'm getting right away that you are making some plans, some brand new plans for your future. It's like you're seeing the bigger picture and you're starting a brand new path here. Knight of Pentacles, that you know is going to take some time to cultivate, but you are making something solid, some solid progress. Okay. And we have the King of Swords, strategizing, making those plans. The King is in it to win it. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. So, you got strong Aquarius here. You could be dealing with an Aquarius some way, shape, or form. But what you are doing is you are there strategizing. You are making your plans. You're being very firm. You're making definite decisions. And it's all about seeing the bigger picture, Cancer. You're seeing that bigger picture. I almost said Capricorn. So some of you might be dealing with a Capricorn, just saying. And we have another page, Page of Pentacles. Well, a page. So you got a lot of pages here. Page with the Ace of Wands is a new plan of action. You have this great idea going on in your head, this new creative idea that you want to implement. And you are definitely have a plan mapped out, or you're mapping that plan out. See that map on the ground? Okay. And I could almost see tearing the page out of that book, like some kind of map, some kind of plan here. Okay. So you are definitely strategizing, and I think you are planning. I think this is a day of planning and thought. Okay, of coming together with a new concept or a new plan, new goals, long-term goals. This could be related to whether to general life, love life, career, Eight of Swords. Okay, so what I'm picking up is you are strategizing. Maybe you feel trapped at some point because of the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, the Knight of Pentacles is holding, or somebody might be coming to you to give you some kind of offer to try to keep you, to stop you from moving forward on a new, in a new direction here. Got the Hierophant under the deck. Let me tell you, I think Gemini got the Hierophant under the deck as well. Hierophant and the Empress. You might have an Empress energy. Somebody who knows their value and worth, or somebody that sees value in you. Okay, and they want to get you into a contract that will keep you bound, keep you from moving forward from your plans that you are trying to implement, from your creative ideas. So just kind of keep that in mind, that you might have somebody working against you more than for you, for their own gain, because they know your value. They know that you are abundant. You are giving birth to a brand new light, to abundance, to money, to whatever. And they want to bind you up to keep you from moving forward. So just kind of be aware of that. You might have to block this person. Eights are blockages. So not only are they trying to block you from moving forward, you might have to block them out so that they don't try to trap you. Okay? Five of Swords, yes, they're in it for their own gain. Okay? They're playing games. They're being tricksters. They're tricksters. Even lies and deception there. Okay, so just kind of keep that in mind. That's what I have for you. Bye. Hello, Leo, Leo, Leo. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Can you believe April's almost over? Holy crap. Okay. Anyhow, Holy Spirit, angel spirits and guides, clarity messages, guidance, please. For Leo, what are the blessed messages for Leo, please? Well, let's see what we have so far. Okay, we have the Page of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Then we have the Chariot, Cancerian energy. We have the Four of Pentacles. Okay. We do have a couple reverse cards here. We have the Star card, Aquarius energy. We have Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. And we have the Queen of Swords in reverse. We have the King of Cups under the deck. More water. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Okay. Leo, 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 Leo. The first thing I need to tell you is you need to see the bigger picture. Okay? You're looking at the picture, but you're framing it in. Okay? You're not seeing the bigger, wider scope of things, okay? That you are definitely at some kind of crossroads, some kind of decision here, that you kind of feel a little bit stuck because you're in this energy, this, you're definitely in bitch mode on the 26th with the Queen of Swords in reverse. The Queen of Swords in reverse is somebody who throws logic out the window. Okay. She is very bitter. She is pissed. So it seems like you're pissed off to no end and you're holding that grudge. Okay. You're holding those emotions in and it is stewing and stewing and stewing. And the King of Cups energy is telling you, hold on a minute. Let's kind of get control here. Let's ground ourselves because his feet are on the ground. Let's ground ourselves. Let's gain control of these emotions that are roaring. Okay. And let's think more positively. Let's turn this Ace of Pentacles upright. And look at the bigger picture of the opportunities ahead. You can't do that when you're caught up in your emotions, when you are in rare form, when you are ready to rip somebody's head off. And that's where you're at. You're ready to rip somebody's head off. Okay? You need to focus. The Queen of Swords, you need to turn her upright and you need to focus, okay? You need to focus on the long-term goals. You need to focus on what you want, what your wish is, where you are headed, okay? You need to have a clear mind. But when you're caught up in your emotions, your mind is scattered everywhere. So that's the energy I'm getting from you, Scorpio. And it's almost like you are getting caught up in a web. You are getting caught up. This is the Seven of Swords, but intuitively, I'm not necessarily seeing the message of lies, but I'm seeing the message of being frantic, okay? Frantic on how to escape, okay? And you desire that new passion and beginning. You have a lot of great ideas in your mind, and you're just going frantically on what to do with them because your mind is scattered, because you're pissed off at somebody, and you're having trouble focusing. Okay, and we have the Queen of Cups here also, which is self-love and self-nurturing is what I'm getting. I feel as though you need to do some meditations. You need to get a grip on your emotions, calm down, settle those emotions down so that you can think clearly on what your move is going to be, because you're there at that impasse, okay? The Chariot wants to move forward, but you're not sure which way you want to go. It's what I'm getting. And let's take one more card out here. The High Priestess. Trust your gut. Trust your intuition. But being in this mode, being in that pissed off mode, being in that over emotional mode gets in the way of your intuition. So, breathe, calm down, and so that you can see the bigger picture, so you can see things clearly. Okay, that's what I have for you. Bye. Hello, Virgo. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26, 2021. Holy Spirit, angels, spirits, and guides, clarity, messages, guidance, please, for Virgo, clarity, messages. Guidance, please, for Virgo. Okay, let's see what we have here. Okay, we have the High Priestess in the reverse. That's Cancer energy. We have the Six of Wands. We have the World. Page of Wands, but okay, the World is Capricorn energy. Page of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Page of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Got two pages here. This may involve children. And we have the Four of Pentacles. And another page. Page of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, three pages. Right away, I feel like you might be dealing with a family issue with children. Okay, just saying. It's almost like you need to recognize what your gut is telling you is what I'm getting here. The High Priestess in the reverse, upright is you. You recognize you're trusting your intuition, okay? In the reverse is you're not trusting your intuition. You're ignoring your intuition. And, you know, the Six of Wands is recognition. It is success, okay? But the another meaning of going with recognition, recognizing your gut feeling. Your back is turned to your gut feeling and you are looking forward, you're looking towards in another direction, okay? The Six of Wands, I mean, is like you're looking for, you're getting recognition. And there's even children here, okay? So I feel like that there's something needing to recognize your intuition here regarding your children, because there seems to be some kind of phase or cycle that needs to come to an end, some kind of completion here that you need to let go of or release. You need to release some kind of energy regarding your children. If you don't have children, this could be brand new paths, new way of thinking, seeking the truth. in a practical plan and being optimistic. So for some of you, you might be very optimistic about a new direction, a new plan. But again, there is this sort of truth, okay? This is maybe even a difficult communication, having a difficult talk with your children. I'm seeing a woman here, maybe the mother of your children, needing to close out some kind of cycle, having a conversation, a really logical conversation with a woman figure. You might even have children acting out, Virgo, that you need, aha, yes, I had an aha moment. You need to nip this in the butt, right? This is closing the cycle, but I feel like the cycle that it needs to close is children acting out that you need to put a lid on it. Need to reel them in and get them under control. Okay, and what I'm getting here is that children are acting out because they want attention. Okay, they want attention. They're lacking attention in some area. I know not all of you have children. This could even be adult children acting out a character, getting in trouble. Okay, however it resonates. I don't feel this is a work related. I don't feel this is love and romance. But I'm feeling like this could even be information, hidden information that comes out regarding your children. You might learn something that may have been hidden from you before, coming to light, coming out. Some information, some difficult information coming out regarding your children. Somebody acting out because they want attention. And it's time to close that. It's time to end that behavior and put a lid on it. Well, that's what I have for you. Bye. Hello, Libra. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angels, spirits, and guides. What are the blessed messages for Libra for April 26th, 2021? Three of Swords. Okay, we have the Three of Swords. We have the Page of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have Temperance, Sagittarian energy. We have the King of Wands in the reverse. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Okay, we have the Ten of Swords in the reverse. Can you say see ya, don't wanna be ya? And the Ace of Swords. Okay, Libra. You are leaving a cheater, a liar, a deceiver, a heartbreaker behind, okay? You were dealing with somebody who was a royally a piece of shit, let me tell you, okay? This person did not know the truth from a hole in the ground, okay? They couldn't tell the truth if their life depended on it. They were a cheater, okay? They had lots of sexual escapades. They broke your heart over and over again, right? They kept on lying to you. Oh, no, it's over. I won't do that again. Bullshit. Okay, and you're like, you know what? I am moving forward. I'm going on. I am not dealing with this anymore. I am not going to let you stab me in the back. Not one more freaking sword. It ain't happening again. Okay, you could take your sword and shove it up where the sun don't shine. It's what I am hearing here, and you are about to bring in balance and healing to yourself. The Ace of Swords is a sword of victory. You are having victory over some heartbreak and pain because you have made the conscious decision that you are not dealing with it anymore. You are moving forward. You are bringing about peace and balance in your own life, screw them, right? And because, yeah, they are a liar. They had multiple people, lots of competition that they put you in. You were competing against other people secretly. They lied about it. They hid it from you. And now you're smugly, you're looking over your shoulder. That tower's falling and you're saying, fall, baby, fall. Burn, baby, burn. It's what I'm getting here. And, you know, they are not gonna be happy. They're gonna come at you like a tiger and say, well, it's your fault, or I did it because of this or that. I'm sorry, you know. And you're gonna, you are like, no, I'm blocking those wands. I am the Empress. I hold the cards. I am the one of value. Sorry, don't see ya. Don't wanna be ya. I am perfectly fine on my own. I am giving birth to new life. I am giving birth to abundance and love. Love for myself. Harmony and happiness. And I will find my Ten of Pentacles. I'm going to go after my happiness and my Ten of Pentacles. I know my value. I know my worth. Here she is again with the Queen of Pentacles. I know my value. But that's what I have for you, Libra. Bye. Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angel spirits and guides, clarity, messages, guidance for Scorpio. What are the blessed messages for Scorpio, please? Okay, we have two cards here. Okay. Let's see, what do we have so far? Okay, we have the King of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have the Queen of Wands. Wow, we have a true pair, maybe a twin or soulmate here. And we have the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, I feel that this is almost like a power couple, passionate couple. The sex is out of this world between the two of you. Okay? And growing and cultivating something. You have a big investment. This is probably a long-term commitment. If this is not love and romance, this could be a partnership. Both of you are on the same page and you are starting to see starting to reap your rewards. You're starting to see the money rolling in. Now, what is drawing my attention is the cat. Cats are sneaky and that cat is trying to take one of the pentacles. So, what I am getting here, Scorpio, is whether this is love and romance or if this is business, work, family, you know, you are not exactly paying attention to the fruits that are coming in because somebody is trying to be sneaky and steal something from you. Okay. Let's see where this is going here. We have the Hermit, Virgo energy. So what I'm feeling is this King of Wands may have withdrawn from the connection because his attention's being directed to a different pentacle someplace else. Okay, that's what I'm getting. He's withdrawing because his pentacle is going someplace else. Six of Pentacles. Yeah, you are putting in all the work. Okay. You are the generous one. The King of Pentacles is the one who's being withdrawn. Okay. Now, the roles can be vice versa. You know, this could be a man and that could be a woman. A woman with masculine energies, a man with feminine energies, however it resonates. But this woman is somebody who's very fiery and passionate and knows what she wants, okay? And goes after it. The king, he takes action and he is very strategic. Sometimes the king acts without thinking though, okay? He is a master of passion. He's a master in the bedroom, you know, and I feel like he's spreading his wealth someplace else. I feel like he is given to somebody else. We got three people in here in this card, okay? Sometimes I don't always see that as three people in a scenario, but it's like somebody's here giving out to two people. And it's not one person's getting more than the other person. So it is not an even give and take here. Okay. I'm sorry to say this, Scorpio, but I think you got a cheater. I'm surprised that king didn't come up in reverse, but sometimes I don't. I feel like the reverse energy is there. Okay. We'll take them. Okay, we have the Four of Swords. You know, this is needing to take a break, needing to take a time out. So I'm getting very strong energy of withdrawal, taking a break, taking a time out. Okay, we've got the Four of Swords here. You know, somebody, this is rest and recovery. So, you know, I think somebody is trying to steal from you, somebody's attention. Somebody that's being sneaky, their attention is somewhere else, okay? You're trying to tend to the relationship or the connection or the partnership, and their attention is someplace else. They're giving it in another direction. And it's like they're very complacent, very lethargic towards this connection. They're not putting in any work at all. They're very withdrawn. And I feel as though We have Emperor Aries energy, and we have the Eight of Swords and the Eight of Cups. So what I feel that this is you putting down some boundaries, okay? Putting down the boundaries, and somebody doesn't like it, and they are feeling trapped. And, you know, it just might be time to walk away from this. Because this is not emotionally fulfilling for either one of you. And I feel as though that it's time to cut the chains. Time to let them go. Time to be the boss. Time for you to take the bull by the horns and take control here. Okay? It's time you stop letting them call the shots. And it's time for you to call the shots. They have kept you bound. They have kept your heart bound long enough. It's time to abandon ship. You know, it's time to let this go. It's time you take control. If they feel fenced in, if they don't like it, tough shit. See ya, don't wanna be ya. You know, goodbye. You are the weakest link. Goodbye. You know, that's the way it is. You know, and move on to something that would be fulfilling to you. Move on to true happiness and healing. Brighter days ahead. Leaving something emotionally unfulfilling towards happiness. Okay, that's what I have for you, Scorpio. Bye. Hello, Sagittarius. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angel spirits and guides, clarity, messages and guidance, please, for Sagittarius. What does Sagittarius need to know for April 26th, 2021? Okay, let's see what we have so far. We have the Two of Pentacles, and we have the Temperance card, which is your energy, Sagittarius energy. So I feel this is about balance. Okay, bringing something back into balance. This could be making choices and decisions towards healing, towards harmony, restoration of harmony. because you've been carrying this heavy load all yourself that's been definitely imbalanced. The responsibilities have been all on your shoulders here. We have this the Ten of Cups here. That's harmony and happiness within the family. We have the Knight of Cups. Somebody's acting very immaturely. We do have messages of love. And what I feel is that, you got a couple other cards here. We have the Devil in the reverse, Capricorn energy. Okay, and we have Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Then we had this one, which was the Eight of Pentacles. Okay, what I get here, Sagittarius, this could be business, this could be love life. You know, general life, business, love life. But I'm feeling more emotional because of the Ten of Cups and the Knight of Cups. Okay, I feel that somebody has been a player. Okay, somebody was very uncommittal. And because they were uncommittal, that you carried the load of the responsibility while somebody wanted to play. Somebody was very immature, okay? And it feels like very flighty, the energy I'm getting is somebody who likes to spread the love but doesn't want the commitment, okay? I feel as though that there may have been some, you know, but there was something addictive about this person's energy, okay? And, you know, when you were around them, they made you feel good, right? There was this blissfulness, this happiness, but there was some kind of toxic energy about them because they were non-committal. They could not, and they would not put the work in. They left the load on you. They left the financial responsibility on you, the workload on you, the emotional load on you, okay? And it weighed you down. So the energy that I feel that you are going in is about making the decision to restore some balance here, okay? To maybe even put your foot down, release this energy here, and, you know, put your work into someplace else. There may even be movement and change, okay? Changes on the emotional status. Changes as far as maybe even leaving this connection because you're like, well, if they're not going to settle down, if every time the talk of marriage, maybe talk of marriage comes up, they talk a good talk and then all of a sudden they get cold feet and they want to fly. That's what I'm getting. When it comes to a commitment, moving in together, leveling up, going beyond the date or the friends with benefits or whatever the connection is, because they are intoxicating and they kind of pull you back in, but every time it gets down right down to commitment, they fly away, okay? And they leave you holding the load. But I feel as though that is turning around. I feel that, you know, I think the blockages from moving on from them officially, maybe it was money, I don't know. This might even have been a relationship that stemmed in the workplace, because this is a work card, okay? Now, for some of you in work relationships, this could be something when it comes time to buckle down and get the work done and work together as a team. They go off to the break room or they go on a smoke break or they call off. They're nowhere to be found type of energy and you got to carry the load. So however that resonates with you. Yeah. And it's like this feeling of being trapped in this cycle here. And, you know, it's like you're not getting out of what you are putting into it. And it's time that the manager steps in. Maybe you are the manager. Maybe you have to put the foot down. Maybe you have to, like, lay the rules down. This is somebody who manages the money, who manages the family. This is somebody who's loyal and committed. And I'm feeling as though as maybe it's time that you take some action and maybe manifest that into your life and break these chains. I feel like you may be breaking these chains and breaking free, getting on that mindset and going and manifesting an even give and take type of situation and moving forward into something more stable. Okay, that's what I have for you. Bye. Hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angels, spirits, and gods, what are the blessed messages for my Capricorns for April 26th, 2021? Okay, let's see what comes up for you guys. Oh, you got the Four of Wands. King of Swords. You got the King of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You've got, let's see, we have Three of Wands. While you've been patiently waiting for a plan to come in to fruition, we have the Eight of Swords. You've been really caught up in your head over this. And we have the Eight of Pentacles. Okay, you've been really thinking, maybe you've been too stuck on it. Okay, let's get in one more card, please. Spirit, one more card. Okay, we got two. We got the Six of Swords. And we have the Three of Swords. Okay, I feel as though that you are very caught up in this energy, Capricorn, of trapping yourself in your head over a heart break or disappointment of some sort. Yes, this could be general or love life, but you're definitely in this mindset that you're stuck because of some heartbreak that you suffered. Okay, and it's creating these blocks in your life. You're trying to plan, you're trying to move ahead. You want to move forward, trying to move forward past this energy. But you notice this energy's here. It's like kind of like in the way of your plans coming together, in a way of your blessings. Okay? And you're trying to make this grand escape here and try like running from this. It's keeping you trapped. You're trying to run from it. And I feel as though you had this stable situation, maybe even a marriage, or maybe you were in a commitment that you lived like a married couple. You lived together. You acted like a married couple. You may even have referred to him as your husband, or or referred to her as your wife. Okay, male or female. Okay. And I feel like that I feel like you're really stuck on this idea of trying to and being patient and waiting for that stability to return. And you've been stuck on this heartbreak. You've been stuck on this connection. There may have even been a third party here. And you've been stuck on this about getting back together. That I'm going totally intuitively here. This is what Spirit is telling me. That you are stuck on this idea and planning and strategizing a way of getting them back, getting your stability back, getting your marriage back, getting that higher level commitment back, getting your home back. When in essence, that whole idea is keeping you trapped in the past instead of you progressing forward. Under the deck, you need to see the bigger picture, okay? You may be even at this crossroads here, okay? You need to take control of your own self, of your own life. Take control of this fear. Take control and release this bondage. Set your own this is somebody who is domineering. Maybe this person contributes to you being trapped, okay? You were dealing with somebody who likes control. That's what this is, okay? And it's like you have the whole world at your hands. You have your whole life ahead of you. And you're not seeing the bigger picture. You're kind of left standing there looking at your world. I think you are gazing at the past. And I feel as though there needs to be a shift in focus. And to move away from this energy and recognize it for what it is. Okay? It's okay. Go ahead. I think it's time you finally mourn this connection, because it is over, and it's because you are not getting what you deserve out of it, and it is time you recognize that you are being juggled, you are being played. This King of Wands is, he knows what he is doing. The King of Wands might be the one strategizing to keep you hooked in and juggling to people. You need to trust your intuition. And this King of Wands is also keeping secrets. And you know it. You need to, here's more intuition. You need to go within and trust that inner intuition here. Okay. Come on, Capricorn. This is not like you to get so emotionally intertwined and stuck. Let's get moving, Capricorn. You have a whole world that awaits for you. You have a whole future. There is somebody out there who is loyal and stable, who will recognize your value and your worth. Why hold on to something that there is no commitment anymore? Why hold on to somebody who wants to play head games? It's time you get your true wish fulfillment. It's time you fly and turn the tables and leave them out in the cold. Okay, that's what I have for you, Capricorn. Bye. Hello, Aquarius. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angel spirits and guides, clarity, messages, guidance, please, for Aquarius. What are the blessed messages for Aquarius? Okay. We have the Chariot, Cancerian energy. This came out next. We have the Nine of Pentacles. We have Nine of Wands. Four of Wands came out after that. Three of Pentacles. The Empress, Taurus, Libra energy. And the Strength card, Leo energy. Everybody's getting seven cards today. Well, not everybody, but most of you. Okay, and Spirit has been really talking. What was supposed to be very short and sweet readings has been drug out. I have a feeling yours is no exception. But you have a lot of pentacles involved here. And a lot of things dealing with stability and abundance. Okay. I feel as though that you may be at this place where you need to choose some kind of direction. You need to gain control of the direction in which you are going. Okay? I feel the decision is going to affect your household, affect a higher level of commitment here. I feel it is dealing with work and career, and about some kind of abundance and independence. Okay, I feel like you are definitely giving birth to something because you are tired and worn out. This may be job and career. Maybe you are working very hard and not getting anywhere, and it's time that you get going. It's time that you have that you're looking for that inner strength. I feel like that you are trying to gain some confidence in the maybe telling your boss, I'm out of here. In love and relationships, this could be, you know, you may have been at it, you might be at a decision between staying single or going into a higher level of commitment here. Okay, somebody may want to work together, collaborate with you. This may even involve three people. And when I'm seeing three people, because I'm seeing the Empress here, you know, you may have been in a connection here. Maybe you were considered yourself single, non-committed yet, but somebody ends up pregnant, which changes the dynamics. It changes everything here. Okay. And now you got to work hard and you're troubled and burdened down. And you feel like that your back is up against a wall or a tree in this picture here. Because now somebody's saying, well, I'm pregnant. Now you got to settle down. That's for some, not for all. And the roles can be reversed. You could be the one that's pregnant and you could be dealing with somebody who is in single-minded mode, you know, and now they feel like their back is up against the wall because now they have a child on the way. That's not for everybody. I know that's very specific. But the strength card here is, I feel, as about having the strength to hold back. So I feel like somebody wants to fly the coop. I feel like somebody wants to jump before thinking things through. It's almost like you need to take some time to really consider your options. Don't rush. Take some time to consider things. Because I feel like your stability, your foundations, even your finances are depending on it. Families depending on it. So I feel you need to show a little bit of restraint before you make the decision to jump ship. That is the main message that I'm getting here. We got the death card. Yeah, this is a big change, a big transformation, an ending. So I'm right on track here. You're thinking about ending either a career, a job, or a relationship because you're running scared. You think your back's against the wall, okay? Because all of a sudden you've got these burdens hanging down over your head and you feel weighed down. You feel trapped, okay? And you're tired. But it's saying you need to show restraint here before choosing that ending. Get those emotions under control here. Master those emotions and think before you walk away. Because, you know, this could end up in a very loving connection. But somebody wants to fly the coop. Okay, either you or them. This could be the person, but I'm feeling this is your energy. Okay, something is going on here that you're thinking of walking away from a situation. Maybe things are getting tough. Maybe there's some arguing going on and things are not running smoothly. Maybe you're not on the same page right now. Okay, maybe you're feeling very much alone and you're at this crossroads. But before you make that decision to divorce or to leave them or to leave that company, get those emotions under control. Think, okay, before you go flying off somewhere and maybe later on regret it. It's saying to have some strength, to show some restraint. Don't act impulsively. Okay, that's what I have for you, Aquarius. Bye. Hello, Pisces. Welcome to your daily reading for April 26th, 2021. Holy Spirit, angel spirits, and guides, what are the blessed messages for Pisces, please? For April 26th, 2021. Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa. Pisces. Holy freaking cow. Okay. Right off the gate, you're dealing with a player. Yes, you are. You're dealing with a freaking cheater. Okay. What we have here is we have the Six of Swords in the reverse. Okay. This is failure to move forward. Okay. Because I feel as though that you're having trouble moving forward past a connection where somebody was juggling two people, where somebody was, you know, being very, very carefree. This is like, this is the Knight of Cups reminds me of somebody who's very flirtatious, okay? Very flighty. They're very alluring as well. They're smooth talkers here, okay? So what I feel is somebody's failing to move on, failing to see the truth, okay, about this person that they were dealing with. This could be in a workplace. This could be in general friendship, love life. But with a judgment call, this is a judgment call. This is Scorpionic energy, okay? We have Scorpio here, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Doesn't have to be those signs, but those are the signs that are popping up. I feel as though that you need to come into this Queen of Pentacles and make a sound, logical decision. Okay? I feel as though that you may have had a wake-up call in the 26th. You kind of leaving the emotions out of it and trying to be practical, what is best for you? Because, you know, this person talks a good talk, but the truth to the matter is they're a player. Okay? There is no success. There is no progress forward with this person. They don't want to move forward. They just want to play and have fun. And that is the hard truth that had to be faced. Okay? There you are being all loving, generous, understanding, patient with this person. And I think that there is a point where you need to draw the line. Okay? It's like you need to be practical, maybe even tell this person, okay, you have to make a decision what you want, who you want. Because I am not going to be juggled. I am not going to be put part of the competition, third party, or anything like that. While you go out and play with all these other women or all these other men, you know, I am not going to accept that anymore. Either things move forward or things have to end. And I think that is a difficult, that is the honest, you know, truthful conversation you have to have, a straightforward conversation with this person. Okay. You may even be starting to see the light and see the truth in the matter. Okay, here we have another freaking queen. Okay, so there's more than two, there's three of you. This person is spreading the love. And this, I'm feeling, is somebody who is very passionate, gorgeous, and, you know, hot to trot. Okay, fun to be around, but not wifey material here. Okay, and this woman here, you know, either this could be two sides of you or two separate women, and this is a third, however it resonates. But this whole situation, especially this one seems, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, seems to cause the biggest threat, okay? And it's causing a lot of drama, a lot of anxiety here. And, you know, she seems to think she has more to offer than the rest of you all to this king, and he's sitting pretty on his throne, everybody giving him everything he wants, and nobody making him settle down and make a decision. So I feel you are definitely at this point at a crossroads. You're third party. You know, it's breaking your heart. But I feel as though you deserve even give and take. You deserve better than being just hanging in there, wondering his next move. End it. Because you have new passionate beginnings awaiting you. Okay? That is going to lead you towards success. Okay, that's what I have for you, Pisces. Bye.